In this video, we will see how to use Guide with MATLAB. Guide is the graphical user interface provided by MATLAB in order to build user interface application with MATLAB. We have multiple ways of opening the Guide application. So the simplest one is that if you type Guide on the MATLAB command prompt, and here we can use the blank GUI default template. This will open a figure. So here we have a lot of options. So this is the select option. We have a lot of buttons. So this is the push button, radio buttons. We have a text box. We have a toggle button. We have pop-up menu. We have access. We have panels. So panels are required in order to create hierarchy in your GUI application. We have tables and we have a list box also. So all these are useful. First of all, let's start with resizing the GUI layout. And we'll put an access box over here. We can resize this access box just by hovering over the mouse there and dragging the edges. We can resize this axis. We can add a panel in order to include radio buttons or the push buttons. So let's resize this panel and then we can add push buttons. We can duplicate these push buttons and we can align these push buttons inside the panel. We can use the align objects tool in order to accomplish this. We can have small adjustment using the arrow key as well. Moving the panel will move the contents inside the panel along with it. Now we'll add the static text and pop-up menu to the GUI layout. The next task is to change the properties. We can do right-clicking the object or go to the view and the property inspector. This should open a window for the object properties in the GUI. The property inspector window allows to set the properties and change the properties for the object. We'll use this to change the GUI title. So you can see the title over here is right-clicking on the panel, right-click on the property inspector will take you to the panel position and change it to say multiple blocks. On the push button, see the property inspector, and then the push button you can say plot was serve mesh and 2D. Now let's change the text for the pop-up menu. Peaks rain and sick. Let's make this contour. The tag properties for the GUI decides which property it belongs to. GUI uses the tags property to identify and generate the functions. For example, if I say here plot popup, the tag properties for the GUI helps in finding the generated MATLAB function, the control generated function. So let's rename this and say plot popup options. We'll repeat this for the other controls. The toolbar editor allows to add your custom toolbar buttons to the GUI. So here you can have your own custom toolbars and add that to the GUI. You can add your own custom push tool, toggle tool, and you can add your predefined menus as well. For this example, we will add zoom in, zoom out, pan, and rotate option. Now running the button in this figure would generate the MATLAB file for the GUI that would actually comprise of the implementation of this GUI, as well as it will generate the fig file. Upon running this, it will ask for you to save this file. In the current tutorials, let me say test GUI. So you can say that here there's one test UI M file and the test UI figure. For now, this is how it looks like. We can observe that the toolbar options are also have been added. Now let's look at the M file. The M file for this particular GUI is the auto generated, and it allows you to give the option of adding some custom codes. What we can do is that for this function, you can use the goto function and look for the test UI opening function. Here in this function, we are going to add the custom code for our pop-up menu options. So this is the custom code that I have written inside the opening function. For the test UI, the command align output would be handle cert output. And then in order to update the handle structure, GUI data edge update handles. So all these are custom codes you can write by looking at the documentation. There's a certain way of writing in it, that's why it might be looking a little strange for you in the first glance, but there's a logic behind this, and to know more about it, you can actually look at the documentation. Here we have defined three data sets and to create initial plots. The handles are used to share data between the GUI functions. We will now switch back to the layout editor again. We can right click and switch the callbacks in order to see the functions used by the auto-generated MATLAB code for that particular push button. We need to insert the code which will get executed whenever the push button is pressed from the GUI. We will repeat this for the other functions. The pop-up callback for the push button will be corresponding to the code that gets executed when the pop-up options are selected. Upon selecting the respective values from the pop-up menu, peaks or membranes or sync, the current data should get updated to the handles. We need to update one more time the handle structure of the GUI. We can copy that from here. Save this file. This makes the GUI complete, and now we can run it.